Hi everyone, this is Lisa from Canine Clips, Dog Grooming Tips, and this is Scarlett, and Scarlett is American Cocker crossed with a Shih Tzu, and she's coming for her full groom today, so I'm going to show you that video of me grooming her without any restraints, and I was guessing just under an hour, so she is going to be getting a longer trim today. Because it is chilly out there. So we're gonna just do a 3/4 inch blade on her today. So it won't take off too much of her body, but it'll clean it up nicely for all those holiday photos that she'll be in. I'm just gonna get all the stuff around her eyes cleaned up. And hopefully you enjoy this video. And if you do, I'd really appreciate it if you would subscribe to my channel. Also check out my channel of all the other videos I do have of me grooming a variety of dog breeds. Some not as well behaved as Scarlett here. She does very well through this process. But I do have some videos of dogs that are a little resistant and maybe a little nippy, give me a little bit more challenging workout, but I can still show you how to do that without any restraints. So I do have some playlists created to help you find those easier as well. So also comment if there's something specific you'd like to see on my channel of me grooming. I'll be happy to help you out best I can. So I'm going to trim around the ear canal so that when I do pluck the ears, I don't want to accidentally pluck this hair here, because it is obviously a different consistency and it would definitely hurt. The hair inside the ear canal does come out quite a bit easier. And it helps prevent anything from the wax from sticking to that hair, making the ears dirty and holding that moisture in there, which can cause some ear infections. Pretty relaxed, but of course I'm still not her favorite person. All right, there we go. She's got the Shih Tzu predominant characteristics, but she's got the cocker ears, really heavy, heavy big ears, because her ears go all the way down to here, which is pretty long for a Shih Tzu, but for a cocker, not so much. Okay, so but she's still a pretty tiny girl. Trim up these feet, get all that hair out of there. And trim up those nails. time of year I'm doing quite a few longer cuts, as it's below 30 degrees Celsius outside. So very chilly. But even with that little bit more fur, it's still cold. We're not going on any leisurely walks, you know, quick and fast, basically, to get that job done. That's about it. Keeping warm inside and snuggling. Okay. Then you got a dew claw. No dewclaw on that one. Okay. Halfway down the feet, baby. She's kind of twisting her foot on me here. This way. Okay, and 1 foot left. Right, careful. Oh, it's okay. One more, baby. Maybe go that fur under there. Makes it a little slippery. Plus, when there's snow, that snow sticks to that fur and makes little fur balls or snowballs, I guess. It kind of gets stuck in there. So by taking this hair out, it helps so that snow doesn't stick. But it's not that we're going out too long, so gotta keep these feet warm too, so don't be outside too long, eh? You're so cute. Just chilling out, eh? Always nice to have a well-behaved dog grooming. Drooling on me. Thank you. Let me clean that up, would you? Little bit extra slobber to share. Hey, don't look at that. One more, baby. Okay, good girl. All right, so there's all the feet done. Now I'm going to comb out her ears. And then I will pluck them. She's going to lay down, looks like. A little thick at the ends. And her owner likes to keep her ears a little longer. But like I said before, they are already long because they more have the cocker characteristics. So her ears actually are all the way down to here. So for her, you know, that's quite a bit. A little bit on this little girl. But her ears are healthy. When the ears are, they're a little bit red, but they still are healthy. So if they were to get, you know, chronic ear infections or whatever, then you want to take those ears short as you can. Get them a little bit lighter for her. That would help keep the ears a little bit drier, because when she shakes, you want to keep those ears nice and dry. Hair's a little bit long in there. Get that all out, and there's some wax sticking to it, so a little bit thicker, so this will definitely help get that redness out. That wax is sticking in there and kind of irritating it a little bit. So there is the hair in that ear. Good girl. About this one. Mm-hmm. All right. Okay, so I'm going to pluck these ears out as well. And got some long hairs in there. There we go, and that's from that ear. Okay, so now we're gonna comb out her tail. And kind of trim that up as well. And because I am keeping her body long, I'm gonna try using the clippers on it before the bath. I'm not gonna be taking that much off. And then I want to finish it up after the bath as well, because that'll help give it a little bit cleaner. But because I'm keeping the hair longer, I'll be able to get her a nice cleaner in the tub as well. Okay. Good girl. Just a few little tangles in there. There we go. Okay, so since I'm using a 3/4 inch blade, I'm going to use a scissors down here. Okay. Giving me the stare down. Like, what are you doing? Hey, what am I doing? When I'm doing this scissor cut in this area, I just kind of want to take the bulk of it out, and still it's going to be quite a bit shorter than the rest. It does have lots of curls in there, and I want to keep that area nice and clean, because of course that's where stuff likes to stick to, that we don't want sticking to it. So by keeping it shorter, there's less likelihood that that will stick in that area. Good girl. Okay, and then I'm going to use a number 5 clipper blade for the inner legs, and that'll help keep everything in here nice and clean. So she has her chin resting on my hand. There we go. Like she was posing for the camera. Okay. Turn you around. Good girl. Okay. And just finish with a number 10, just in the area where she pees. Just because obviously, again, that's where stuff will stick. And I like to have that nice and close. She's helping check that out. All right. So now I am ready for the bath. Oh, actually, no, I'm going to, sorry, skip back and forth. We're going to do the 3/4 inch blade now. Take a little bit of that bulk off so I can get a nice clean bath on her. Okay, good girl. And she does have very thick fur. When I do the legs here, I kind of use my other hand to pull out the fur a little bit. Because otherwise it wouldn't really catch it. And then anything I can't get, I don't worry about. I'm going to go back and use the scissors. Because it's kind of hard when you have a longer blade like this to get in all those little creases and crevices there. And generally, they're not too excited about having the clipper blade on their legs. But they'll tolerate it for a little bit with me. And using this length of blade, you gotta make sure your dog isn't matted. Otherwise it just wouldn't go through at all. It'll go through a little bit if they're more at the surface. But if the mats are quite a ways down, then they will not go through that. Good girl. Got a little bit of a mat under this armpit. I'm going to use a number 7 to get that out. Just got to be careful when you go under armpits because there's lots of loose skin. It all depends how you lift up that leg. I'll come back to this one because most likely there's one mat on one side, it's on the other side as well. And of course I want them equal to grow the same. There's a little bit of a mat underneath this chest here. There we go. There we go. Okay, good job. Almost done. Alright, there we go. So I'm just gonna check underneath her belly here. Yeah, there's a little spot right here I couldn't get to. And I am just gonna use the number 10 blade just for under her belly as well. And that'll keep it nice and clean. Right, come up. Bit of a mat there. There we go. Get that out. There we go. Okay, so now she's ready for her bath. Good girl. Trim that off her head. Just take a little bit. I don't think I did the head, top of the head. I'm going to do that before the bath. There we go. Okay, okay.
shower.
Spray power. Feet and legs. Okay, there we go. Drain out a bit here. So I do have a tub stop in there to catch that hair. And I like to kind of feel them out here and kind of get as much water as I can out of my hand, but then I can also see if there's any soap residue as well, so I want to make sure there isn't any, otherwise it can make the dog quite itchy when the water does dry, and you don't want any of that left on the dog. Good girl. There we go. Good girl. Okay. Okay, I'm getting you. All right, I'm gonna take her. Get it so quick. And get her to the back to the table. There we go. extra towel dry because her fur is so thick. Rash with those ears. It'd take me a little bit longer to dry her. Alright, good girl. Alright, so I'm gonna put some ear scarf on, protect her ears, leave them hang out a little bit so I can hopefully dry that part. And here we go. Big fan of the blow dryer, especially on her legs for some reason. But every dog's a little different, so I will work with her. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to use the 3/4 inch blade again just to clean up the body. Gonna add a bit of oil. There we go. It's not taking out a lot, but still, just clean it up any stray ends in there that are sticking up. There we Alright, so I'm going to use the blow dryer one more time here without the head scarf on. just to try to get her head a little bit drier, but she really doesn't like the blow dryer, so it'd probably be quick. And just she's one of those dogs that's gonna be going home damp. I just don't like the, if they're stressed out, I don't like to cause any more stress than I have to. And that's what I decide to do. So here we go. That is enough. Yeah, it's a good girl. I know you don't like it. So she is quite damp, so her hair will look a little stringy. But it'll dry. I'm just gonna get some mats out of her ears. There we go, good girl. That's why with her, I try to predominantly do the main cut before the bath, because she really doesn't like the blow dryer, and I don't really want to stress her out any more than I have to. Any last tangles out here? There we go. So there is the full groom of Scarlet here. So hopefully you enjoyed that. And we'll check out my channel to see other videos that I have on there, as well as just cute little clips of just unique things that I see on a day-to-day basis. So thanks for taking the time to watch. I appreciate that. And hope you have a great day. And we'll see you again.